Hello everybody! So this new video is actually inspired by what I did about 2 weeks ago where I switched up the ink in my Pentel pocket brush pen. That inspired me to find the perfect black that I can use with any medium, whether that is watercolors or alcohol-based markers, especially with alcohol-based markers, because the Pentel ink is awesome, but it always smudges when you put it down to the paper before the markers. So to start out finding the perfect black ink, I went to gulaipens.com and I got the ink sample package called Blacks Water Resistant. The inks that come in the package, in the sample package that I will be testing out, are the Diatramentis Archive ink in black, all of them are in black, the Diatramentis Document ink, Noodler's Bad Black Moccasin, Noodler's Black, Noodler's Black Eel, Noodler's Heart of Darkness, Noodler's X Feather, and Platinum Carbon Black. And then as a bonus, because I had them and I wanted to try them out as well, I am also testing the Iroshizuku Takasumi and the Higgins Fountain Pen India ink. As for tools, I am using both a brush and dip pens, and then for the dip pens, I wanted to try out both a flex nib and a calligraphy stub. This one is 1.9 millimeters. And then I also wanted to try them in every paper that I am currently using, in every notebook, just so I have that reference sheet where I tried them out, and every time I want to use one of these black inks in the notebook, in that particular notebook, I can see how they respond to the paper. So I'm using the Baron Fig, Render Crescent, Tomoe River Paper, the Moleskine Sketchbook, not the original one, but the sketchbook version, the Rhodia Dot Pad, and the Midori Notebook Cotton. And then I created this little chart with enough space in one single page to test all 10 inks, the 8 from the sample, and the 2 bonus ones that I am adding. And then I went ahead and tried out the flex nib, the calligraphy stub, and the brush in every single ink, in every single paper. Here you can see an overview of what they look like. Now I'll go into detail into what my findings were and what I think is best for each medium. So first one is for watercolors, which as you can see, yes, they're water resistant and they're permanent. They're permanent inks. However, they're not waterproof. All of them smudge when I brush them with water, which means that I'm still on the hunt for the perfect black ink to use with watercolors, because it makes sense, these are water-based and they do stay, as you can see, they don't smudge exactly, but they wouldn't work when painting with watercolors. As for using them with alcohol markers, the Noodler's Bad Black Moccasin was absolutely perfect. You can see there that just nothing moved, absolutely nothing. The Iroshizuku Takasumi was a good runner-up. It was almost perfect. You can't really see it on camera very well, but the alcohol marker in the Takasumi brings out some undertones in the ink, so it's not perfect, but it's almost perfect. If that's all I had, I would use it. However, the Bad Black Moccasin was just nothing moved. Absolutely not. I highly recommend this for using with alcohol markers. Then I wanted to test out the Bleeding Ghosting Situation, which both in the Moleskine Sketchbook and in the Render Crescent, as expected on that one, of course, there was minimal ghosting in Moleskine, but almost nothing. That other page is completely usable. And then in the Render Sketchbook, there's absolutely nothing, because that's the point of that sketchbook. Now, the Tomoe River paper, although it's not the worst at bleeding, it was the worst at ghosting. You can see absolutely everything in the next page, which is why I wouldn't use this paper as for journaling purposes or planner purposes, for example. It is awesome paper for inks. It brings out the best in inks, but the paper is very thin and you can see absolutely everything through, and it does bleed, as you can see, especially with the flex nib. Most of the bleeding happened with the flex nib. Then the Baron Fig was pretty bad at with the bleeding. As you can see, there's some smudges, but it's not bad at all with ghosting, and the bleeding really only happened again with the flex nib. So if you're using these inks only in a brush or with a stub, or for normal writing, I assume, the Baron Fig works very well. I actually use Baron Figs right now for my bullet journaling, and I use fountain pens often for planning almost for everything, actually, except the decoration part. And I rarely have problems. I only have bleeding barren fig when I accidentally hold the pen too long or something like that, or go over something twice or three times. Then next was the Midori cotton, which is an in-between. So it did bleed and it did go through, but the bleeding only happened, as you can see, with testing the alcohol markers, because alcohol markers will always bleed. That's just, I accept that fact of life. Except for the render sketchbook, they always bleed. And again, the flex nib. But anything else, it ghosts. It, you can see everything, but it doesn't bleed through. And then finally, the Rhodia dot pad, that's the one that bled a lot, that bled the worst. Even with the brushes, you can see it just goes through everything. So Rhodia dot pads are good for testing out inks and seeing them in one side of the page. However, just make sure you cover the following page with a scrap paper so you don't ruin other pages. But there's no way you can use this paper in both sides. Next category was color intensity. I wanted to note some weird thing that happened with the Noodler's Black Eel. It looks indeed, like the name suggests, like it's in water. I put it down and it would, I don't even know how to call that. It looks like it eroded with the water. It looks as if the ink was overly watery, and it creates these little bubble gray spots, which you can see there. I'm not sure how to call that, but that happened. So that's a major reason why I would not use this ink with brushes ever again. It worked okay with other mediums. However, definitely the best one, hands down, for color intensity was the Platinum Carbon Black. The Noodler's Heart of Darkness was a good runner-up, but Carbon Black was just absolutely black. Next category would be how they perform with flex nibs, which here is where the flow and feathering really comes out. I have three favorites in this category for different reasons. Well, really two favorites. The Platinum Carbon Black is definitely, hands down by far, the one with the best flow. This ink just flowed perfectly through the flex nib. I didn't have to force it through. I never had that empty double line that you sometimes get with the flex. That never happened. I didn't have to redip after every letter. I tried out writing in a quick sample paper a whole sentence and I only had to redip once. So two dips and you get a whole sentence, which doesn't always happen with flex nibs. Actually, very rarely. However, the feathering situation is not perfect with this ink. It had some minor feathering. It's something that I'm okay with if it's for something personal, like for journaling, or if I'm just practicing flex writing, which of course I want to not struggle with the flow of the ink when practicing, but you know, the feathering is not as important. However, if I were writing something that's for someone else or for display, I would not use this ink. It's a dream to work with, but it feathers and it just doesn't look neat when it's dry. Now, then I tested the Diatramentis document ink, and that was the best of both worlds. That was almost perfect. It doesn't feather at all. It didn't feather in any paper. It was beautiful, the final product, but it flows well. It has decent flow. It's not as smooth as the Platinum Carbon Black. It's not annoying to work with. You have to redip more though. You have to be aware that every few letters, if it's a short word, you're good. If it's a long word, maybe you're fine after using it for, you know, 10 minutes or so of usage, then it starts flowing better. But especially at first, you have to redip a lot. And then my two runner-ups, just for finishing purposes, the Noodler's X Feather and the Noodler's Black had beautiful final results. They do not feather at all in any paper. However, they are a pain in the butt to use. Some of them, I think it was the Noodler's Black, it just would get stuck in the middle of the nib and it wouldn't come down. That applies for both of them, actually. They would just get stuck in the middle of the nib and they don't really flow through the slit of the nib, let alone when the flex separates and opens the nib. They have beautiful results. They just take forever to get even one letter, let alone a whole paragraph. Next category is calligraphy stub, specifically for Gothic or black letter calligraphy, which is what I tend to use those nibs for. Now here it is very easy to pick my favorite. It was definitely the Noodler's Bad Black Moccasin. It was awesome. Just absolutely zero feathering. And I mean, doing calligraphy with a stub, it's more forgiving on feathering than it tends to be on Flex. Flex is, will bring out all the feathering, but with the stub, it brings it out as well. And the Bad Black Moccasin was actually the one that acted the best. It was a smooth riding experience. The flow was good. I didn't have to redip after every letter. Actually, I think I did that A in all six notebooks without redipping, which was nice. And then some runner-ups, because also they have pretty good flow and they didn't feather, were the Noodler's X Feather, as the name would imply. It actually had beautiful results as well. The Noodler's Heart of Darkness was very good, even though it was absolutely horrible, as you can see there with the Flex. And then the Platinum Carbon Black was actually gorgeous as well. So it depends on what paper I would be using it, although all four of these worked very well in every paper. And finally, some final thoughts and conclusions. If I had to pick only one, I would pay attention to what it is that I use inks for the most. So I tend to, on a weekly basis, if not daily basis, use ink for black lettering and gothic lettering with stubs. So that makes the Noodler's Bad Black Moccasin a priority for me, because it was my favorite with that medium. And then also it was the best with alcohol-based markers, which I use a lot for drawing as well, very often. So, and that was actually my original purpose of looking for these, because I couldn't find a brush pen that is good, that I like the brush of, and that is alcohol resistant. So for that, those two reasons, Noodler's Bad Black Moccasin is my number one pick, and if I could only get one, that's the one I would get. Now, I would really like to be able to get two, because the Diatramentis Document Black has some qualities that the Bad Black Moccasin lacks, like for example, the perfect flow and lack of feathering with Flex nibs. I wouldn't be able to achieve that as well with the Bad Black Moccasin. It actually did feather. So for Flex nibs, both dip and fountain, I would definitely pick the Diatramentis Document Black. So those would be the two that I would definitely buy full sizes of. I also really enjoyed the shading in the Diatramentis Document Black. Higgins and Hiroshizuku have better shading. They're wetter inks and they just have a wider variety of shading when you put down the letters. But among the ones in the sample set, the Diatramentis Document was the best one in terms of shading. It has some interesting variety going on. And then as for a runner-up, it's not the number one absolute must, but I would definitely like to get a full size of, is the Platinum Carbon Black, just because of the intensity. It has the most intense, deep black out of all of them. And while sometimes it's really nice and awesome to see the shading and see that variety in the ink, sometimes, especially with a brush, I want just solid, intense black that doesn't look gray at all. And this would be it. This is the blackest black out of the bunch. And it's just good overall. It was quite water resistant. It doesn't, even though it does provide some shading when you wipe it with water, it doesn't go away. It's definitely very permanent. So it does have that good resistance. It wasn't the worst at bleeding. And it is also very good with the calligraphy stub for gothic and black lettering. So it works very well for me in that perspective as well. So that is pretty much it. I'd love to hear what your favorite ones are and if you've tried any of these. I will link below the video where I changed up the ink in the Pentel pocket brush pen, so you can check out how to do that and do it with one of these inks if you'd like. And that's all. See you next week in the next video, and have a fantastic day. Bye.